everyone, this is Preeti. We are here with the another question of exercise 9.2, page number 159, question number 5. In the figure PQRS and ABRS are the two parallelograms, and next is any point on the side BR. This is the side BR, this is the point X. Show that we have to show these two parts. So start with the first one. In the first one, we have to prove that the area of PQRS, the area of this parallelogram is equal to the area of ABRS. We have to prove these two things in the first one. So first, I'm going to take the triangle PSA and the triangle QRB. So this is the triangle PSA and the triangle QRB. This one and this one. We are having these two triangles here. Now, angle SPA is equal to the angle RQB. Why? Because they are the corresponding sides from PS is parallel to the QR. This is the PS, this is parallel to the QR. This is a parallelogram, so they are the corresponding angles. And there is a transversal PB. This is the transversal PB. This one is the transversal. So these two angles are equal. Now angle PAS is equal to the angle QBR. This is the angle PAS and this is the QBR. Now they are equal. Why? Because they are the corresponding angles. We are going to write here corresponding angles. They are also the angles. I have written here the side. They are the corresponding angles. Because AS is parallel to BR. This is AS. This is parallel to the BR. And we have transversal PB. So they are the corresponding angles. Now the angle PSA is equal to the angle QRB. Now this one is equal. Why? Because they are, because of the angle sum property. So I'm going to write here angle sum property. This is the PSA, this one. Now the angle QRB, this one. Now if we are going to add them, then they will be equal to the 180 because of the angle sum property. Because these two angles are equal, then third one will also be the equal. So we are going to write here PS is equal to the QR. This is the PS, this is equal to the QR. Why? Because they are the opposite sides of the parallelogram. Which parallelogram? The parallelogram PQRS. This is the PQRS. They are the opposite sides of the parallelogram. Now we are having three equations. This is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. Now, from these points, from 1, 2, and 3. So, from 1, 2, and 3, we know that the triangle PSA is parallel to the triangle QRB. Now, these two triangles are congruent by the angle side angle congruence rule. We are having one side and two angles as equal. So now they are congruent to the each other. So I'm going to write here area of ट्राइंगल पी एस ए, द एरिया ऑफ द ट्राइंगल पी एस ए इज इक्वल टू द एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल क्यू आर बी. वाई? नाउ वी हैव प्रूव दैट दे आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू द ईच अदर. नाउ कॉन्ग्रुएंट फिगर्स हैव इक्वल एरियाज, वी नो दिस थिंग. सो वी आर गोइंग टू राइट हियर congruent figure have equal area, that's why area of these two triangles are equal to the each other. Now we are going to take the parallelogram PQRS. So area of parallelogram PQRS, this one. Now in this one is equal to the PSA plus triangle PSA. Now the triangle PSA plus parallelogram. Now in this one if I'm going to add the parallelogram AQRS. 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 In this one if I'm going to PQRS, this one is the parallelogram. In this one, if I, this one is equal to the PSA, this triangle plus this parallelogram. So this one will be the equal to the parallelogram PQRS. So now as we know that the triangle PSA is congruent to the triangle QRB, so at the place of PSA I can write QRB. So area of parallelogram PQRS is equal to the triangle QRB plus parallelogram AQRS. So now we are having this thing. So now we have the triangle QRB, the triangle QRB plus the parallelogram AQRS. So if we are going to add this one, then we are going to get the parallelogram ABRS. ABRS. So we are going to write here area of parallelogram PQRS is equal to, at the place of this one, we are going to write the area of parallelogram. If we are going to add both of them, then this will become the parallelogram ABRS. So I'm going to write here area of parallelogram ABRS. This one we have to prove that area of parallelogram PQRS is equal to the area of parallelogram ABRS. So we have proved with this one, we have solved the part 1. Now comes to the part 2. In the part 2, we have area of the triangle AXS. AXS, this is the triangle, is equal to the area of PQRS. This one we have to prove. So the triangle AXS and the parallelogram ABRS are on the same base and in between same parallel lines. Now this is between the two parallel lines, the AS and BR. This is the AS, this is the BR. BR and AS. So now we are going to write this one, because we know the relationship between the area of triangle and the parallelogram. Area of triangle AXS is equal to the half of area of parallelogram ABSR. So they are half of this one. Now as we know that in the last one we have proved that the parallelogram ABRS, this one is equal to the this one was equal to the area of AQRS, area of parallelogram AQRS plus area of triangle QRB. This one we was having in the part 1. So now at the place of QRB we are going to write the triangle PSA. So I'm going to write here half of area of parallelogram AQRS plus area of, now at the place of QRB I'm going to write the triangle PSA. The triangle PSA. Now we know that the AQRS, this is AQRS. If I am going to add PSA in this one, PSA, if I'm going to add this one, so this will be PQRS. So I'm going to write here, this will be equal to the half of area of PQRS. This is AQRS. This is AQRS. In this one we have added PSA. So this will become PQRS. So half of area of PQRS. This is equal to the area of triangle AXS. This one we have to prove. Proved it. This is the part 2. With this one we have completed the question number 5. In the next video we are going to start with the question number 6.